shall and will not slumber. Behold, he that keepeth Israel shall neither slumber nor sleep. For the Lord is that keeper. Anybody in here that can testify that you can care about God? Is there anybody in here you can pray with Mr. McGhee that you can care about God? Is there anybody in here who can affirm that you could have lost it? You've been kept in the hands of the man who created.
Yes, yes.
The waters, oh my God. Do I have any witnesses that can just wave at me that I am a walking, talking, on the cross, and he declares that while, oh my goodness, that while he's hanging on the cross, his conversation is directed toward heaven. Oh my goodness, not with me in the second place. I only got 2 points, and I'm at my second point right now. He says, into thy hands I commend my spirit. And when we talk about the hands of God, we're speaking about the anatomy of God. Oh my God, because the Father's hand speaks of trustworthiness.
Yes.
Because there is no better hands to be in than to be in our Lord's hands. Oh my goodness, men will let you down, but when you're in the Father's hands, would never leave me. Y'all can sit up, y'all can talk to me. I ain't gonna bite you. I want you to know, oh my goodness, that because when Jesus was in the hands of man for those last 18 hours of his life, he was arrested illegally at the hands of man. He was stripped of his garments at the hands of man. He was whipped until his flesh can I get those same ones that were so enthusiastic about you? actually a banker's term. It denotes a transaction from one hand to the other. So when Jesus said, I commit, I'm putting my life in your hands. And if I put, hold on, wait a minute. It's letting us know, because it's a banker's term.